Okay, this is a torch, human right torch relay. So it's the light from the end of the tunnel. And this is the beginning of the relay in Washington DC coming down from Boston.
Today is on April 6th, Sunday afternoon. We are in Washington DC, the capital city. Crowds are waiting, are welcoming the global human rights torch. This is a torch about Olympic to raise the public awareness of human rights situation in China. The torch was lighted 9 months ago in Athens, Greece. And in the past 9 months, it traveled around the world, about 30 countries, about 100 major cities. Today, the torch, human rights torch, arrived to Washington, D.C. And here, I'm standing in front of this memorial for victims of communism. This is the first stop. A week ago, the torch arrived to Boston. And it's 1 week later, the torch arrived Washington, D.C. We are going to welcome the torch to the capital city. We have a brief ceremony here. Then our main site will be over the Freedom Plaza.
Visitors from different communities. We got the Laotian ambassadors. We have Sudan ambassadors. And these people will come up and get their torches lit from one of the original torches that has traveled all around the world. It's gone to several dozen countries, over 150 cities. And that torch is coming here today to Washington, D.C., and we'll light three other torches, and we will run those torches from the Victims of Communism Memorial, which is right here, which is the goddess of democracy, over to Freedom Plaza. So a lot of symbolism in today's events, and I'm hoping that people will pay attention, because this memorial was christened only last year. President Bush came out, and it shows that people still know that communism is bad for human beings, that it's bad for nations, that it destroys people. And that's what they have to understand. It's really unreasonable for China to have gotten the bid in the first place, and then for them to just make things worse and not to try to improve. That's what we're out here to draw attention to, and to say it can't happen this way. The Olympics are about the human spirit. They're about treasuring the human body, and all that the communists want to do is to destroy people, to keep them weak, and to keep them oppressed, and never let them be free. It's nothing that has anything to do with the Olympic ideals, and I think people will start to pay attention. If they're out on the streets today and they see our runners, they'll pay attention. So
we are against China, because China is the only country in the world is supporting dictatorship in Sudan. They're destroying Darfur, the genocide. They're supporting government against Darfur people. And now they're destroying Nubia, the first civilization in the world. They're building dams, and they have business with the government. They don't care about the genocide committed by the government of Sudan.
My name is Chodin Ponsang, and I go to school here, and I'm from, I'm actually from Vermont. I just moved here a month ago, and I'm in the capital area, Tibetan Association.
How many Tibetans are there?
There are about between 300 and 400 people. Like, not many people showed up here, because they're all at the International Campaign for Tibet, praying for all those people who sacrificed their life for our country, Tibet. Yeah.
And why you come here today?
I'm here to support human rights in general, and to support my country, stand up for what's right, and stand against the Hu Jintao and Wen Jiabao. Tell them to stop lying. They killed more than 140 people. They killed 8 people yesterday, but the Chinese, they say they killed about 16. That's it. But we know they're lying. So.
Are you students too?
Yeah, I'm a high school student. I'm a junior, and I'm here to support Tibet.
You live here with your family?
Yeah, I live here with my family in Virginia.
Yeah, I'm a student in high school as well, and my name is Tenzin Wozer, and I'm here to support Tibet too. Well, I think I feel like better because there's more people who support Tibet. Like instead of only Tibetans, there's other countries as well.
Do you speak any English?
She says it's good here. Like they have, we have like much rights here to do anything we want. So she's really happy here, and she says free Tibet. She's here for vacation. She's gonna go back to India. Yeah, she's here with her son. No, to her son.
She's from India.
She lives in India.